Monty and Marcus. Right, delivery to Cottonwood Foundry. This was by Rich Garber. I can't remember the name of the organisation he had now, but this was by Rich Garber. Right, Cottonwood is two industries, with the foundry being the larger of the two. Drive the short distance to the foundry, drop off the load of coal hoppers. Afterwards, end the scenario by parking your engine at the foundry service. So, there's no timing, so let's have a look at... This is the route. It's a fictional model railway-based one. This is really old. This is one of the first routes that was released by anybody for the game. And it's based on a model railway design. So, we are here at the moment, so we need to pull forwards... and go and get these these ones here. This is what we need to go and get, so let's change that forward. Not quite clear, clearing its way through there. How come I thought this only had three? I was obviously looking at a different route, because this has got standards. Is this classed as TS1? I'm not sure what you mean, Mr. Bossman. Clear the path back out onto M9 and then we can pull forward. Oh, right, okay, so TS1 is this TS. TS2016, all the rest of it. Does TS2016 work on Windows 10? Yep, that's what I'm running on right now. It works perfectly on Windows 10. Did it turn off the host notification? The host notification only reports now if it's two or more viewers on the other stream. It was getting to be a distracting spam otherwise. Player train has left the path. What? How have I left the path? Game over in 29 seconds. Not sure how else I was supposed to do it. Oh, here we go. Now it's back on again. It's an old setting no one uses anymore, that game. If you're off path, it flies up the... you're going to be game over in a minute. They wanted me to go another way. I'm not sure how it would expect me to do it. Sure, going through those wagons and up that way, but then I've got a couple to the front. Yeah, I'm not sure what other way I could have gone. When will the Euro Truck Sim stream get uploaded? Soon. I don't know exactly when. It's quite a fun route, this Coplopper Mount. Because it's a model railway, it's sort of a different tone or different pace to most the railroads. And Rich was quite good at populating areas of scenery and making and sort of filling out little sets of set pieces and towns and that sort of thing, bringing it to life. Right, go via D11. Where's D11? Sim247, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. Do you export to YouTube using Twitch? Yes, I do. Perverted Mexican! It's a new username, I guess. Thank you for the follow, much appreciated. It's Bink, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. All aboard, that was it. All aboard was the name of the organisation, thanks Francois. What's with the map in the bottom left? Well, this is a fictional route, so it's not going to be showing real railways. No, I thought your scenario was very good, GWR. Really enjoyed it. Coasting along. Go via D7, that's where we're going. So we're going around the loops now, so we're going to make our way round this bit, and we are aiming to drop back off at Foundry. So we're coming round. Ah, we're going to come back and then push them back down to there. Okay, so we need to stop once we get to the junction. How do you make TS16 run a lot smoother? So I'm running a 980 Ti and a Skylake processor running at 4 point something gigahertz. And this is a really old route, so it's... Right, so now we've changed the switch, we now need to push it down into here, which is that one and that one. No, missed, fail. There you go. Drop those off there. I think I need to go around the outside. Well, it's changed the switch. If I go around the outside... I guess I could go around the outside. That would get me in the other way round. It told me I had to drop the thing off somewhere else. I don't know where on earth I'm dropping... where it said to drop it off now. Because there's not any instructions. I'm presuming there was a... Never mind, we'll see. We haven't got to go that way. I'm off path and I'm going to get end of scenario in a moment. Seconds, go end scenario. I hate that mode. Boom. Let's just try that one more time. There's a reason no one uses that mode anymore. No, it's an old option that was used in early train sim scenarios because someone thought it made good gameplay. But everyone's learned that it doesn't. Everyone hates it. Don't do that. Is Intel Celeron processor okay? I don't know off the top of my head. What graphics have you got? Yeah, not a lot more, no, it's pretty lightweight. Graphics are going to be the root of what kills it though. When was the scenario made? Probably about 2009. We'll do a little bit of Skylines tonight, but not much. Kind of want to play a bit of Skylines, but probably only half an hour at most. It now reckons we're going the wrong way. I have no idea what way it wants me to go, but let's get past the... rubbish. Right. Yes, workshop support came in with TS-13. I was the one who pioneered it all, got it all set up. Got people uploading the first 50 scenarios. All the scenarios that have got a P in the name at the beginning, those are all the Pioneer Team scenarios. They were the very first scenarios uploaded. I should have made a note where it wanted us to put the scenario. Put the loco at the end. Will I PM people when their scenarios are blocked? No, I don't. To be honest, I sort the scenarios out at the beginning of the stream, and I'm generally running behind schedule every night anyway because of other commitments. So, in case of if you want to watch your scenario, you need to be here. There's a mod that has it so each citizen in your city is named after a Twitch viewer. That's awesome. Sylvester47, thank you for the follow, much appreciated. I've got 6,500 people in my town though, so we need a few more followers. Get to it, folks, get to it. Right, we'll try doing it the right way this time. So it's basically just going to end up back there. So we are going, so it's a model railway like this, it's a loop, so we're going to go round this bit of the loop, and then we're going to cross over, go round that bit of the loop, and then we'll tuck the train in there. I forgot lots of 14Ls, eh, Ruben? Dave, no, I don't have 6,500, what I mean is, we've got 6,500 people in the city, so if we want to name all the viewers, all the citizens after people on our followers, then we need a few more followers, because I don't have that many. It's like a model railway, it's sort of based on a model railway style design, Strat Player. It's not, I don't think it is a model railway someone's built necessarily, but it's based on a model railway style design, using a non-model railway type construction. So if you look at the One House model railway that Phil Tier made, it looks and feels like a model railway. This doesn't. This isn't meant to look like a model railway. It's just the track layout is designed. It then meant that Rich could play around with different ideas for the scenery and so forth. Hey there, Nibby boy. Oh, it's named after current viewers in chat. Oh, we need a few more viewers in chat. Miles to Foundry 3. Just had an ice lolly, now you have an ice headache. Serves you right for not sharing, Gouger. Where are we now? Well, we're running around the top here. No, another ice lolly will fix it. Will I ever play SimSig? At some point, yes, I will play some SimSig, yeah. And you've searched Twitch, Matt, I'm the first suggestion, am I? Excellent, good GG, Google. You want me to get the Dutch panels, Amarillo? Yeah, that'd be, I'm having enough trouble with the German one. How long do you take to recover from a 24-hour stream? What I do is, when I finish, say I finish at 1 o'clock in the afternoon, because I usually do 1 to 1, I'll stay up and be really tired until about 8 or 9 o'clock at night, and then I'll go to bed. And then, by the time I wake up in the morning, completely recovered. So basically, at the end of a 24-hour Twitch stream, I just sit and watch telly all afternoon. I'm usually quite wide awake, to be honest, and I'm hyped. I'm still got adrenaline from doing the stream. It's all the stress of being around you lot. Alright, I'll take a look at the link later, Nimi boy. Would ever do City Skylines multiplayer? Maybe. Haven't really looked at what City Skylines multiplayer is all about. Maybe at some point. I try not to do too many multiplayer things, just because they're great for people who take part, and they're not that interesting for people who are just watching. But I do want to do them occasionally. So I might look at doing City Skylines multiplayer at some point. I think if I don't do Cities in Motion 2 multiplayer at some point, Simon Lund is going to bust something. Right, coming round now. Oh no, we've got the inner loop to do now. idiots are back. Quite nice. Do I have fans on? My computer has got 5 fans in it anyway, quite substantial fans. So I don't really have a problem with it overheating, to be honest. There is a huge fan up there if I need it, but I don't really need it so far. The machine seems to keep itself ice cold. It's got water cooling on the processor. Welcome back, train guy. Where are we at now? We made it round the top. No, we're halfway round the left circuit. Can I not go faster? Well, it's a 40 limit and I'm doing 40. I'm going to say no. Doing 39.9, you think I should speed up here? Slow coach! So let's speed up, I don't want everyone getting upset with my ear. Please do, Ben. Globet C did an experiment on Weir Dale and Teesdale route. Apart from one spot near North Road Station, it's perfectly safe to run at 100 mile per hour between Barnard Castle and Darlington. Nice. Right, we're going around the top of the circuit now. Like on the London Brighton one, I found that you could pretty much, other than that turn into East Croydon, you can pretty much go as fast as you like. Well, I think to remember is that this route was made with rail simulator tools, not rail works or anything newer than that. Are there any stations? No, this is American freight. I can't remember whether Rail Simulator had a crossover tool. I'm sure I had the A4 at 100 mile an hour, but you can't go much above that. It's in that general area, though. This route reads an updated version with better scenery. To be honest, there are other routes to spend time on rather than just updating old routes. There are new routes that everyone wants to see. Right, we're working our way round now. Let's set the junctions up to go the right way. That puts us in the right way. Yeah, well, again, there were no 3D trees when this route was made, I don't think. Map looks like the Christmas route. Right, there's Foundry 3. Yeah, I was going to try one of BNSFs the other day, but I couldn't find it. Oh dear, getting some transmit errors going up to Twitch now, so apologies for lag. Stop any time now. Jeez. Couple. Great job. Park the engine at Foundry service where the scenario will end. We've got to be very careful how we get there, so otherwise the game gets upset and uppity and with the scenario, and the scenario will end anyway. Yeah, it is white meat. It's basically just on two circuits of the loop, because it's a railway. It's a model railway, so it is all about the loops. I mean, from where you start, you can't actually access this yard, so you could pass it, short of then pushing them back down like I did, which would have been quicker. But so you end up going all the way round, because again, the way model railways work is you take a long journey and fold it down over itself, so you can do round and round and round and round and get there without having to do more than an 8x4 layout. Great job, park the engine at the foundry service where the scenario will end. That's what I said, wasn't it? Oh, okay. I didn't need us to actually park it there. Excellent. Well, there you go. Delivery to Cottonwood Foundry. Gosh, this is back in the old days. So it's amazing how much has moved on, both in way we write scenarios, the way we build routes and so forth. But it still stands out. It's a good route, considering when it was built. So there's some interesting possibilities to be had there, I think. I'm going to run some more scenarios of that over the coming weeks and show more of it. Right, so stream quality has gone downhill by the looks of it. I'm going to go and have a very, very short toilet break, and then we will get on and we'll do a little bit of City Skylines for maybe 3/4 of an hour until 12:30. All right then, folks, thanks very much for watching. If you're sticking around, I'll see you shortly. And if you are, if you're not sticking around, thanks for watching. And I will see you tomorrow at 8 o'clock. No. Wednesday, 7:30 p.m. for Minecraft. And after Minecraft, this week we're doing Farming Simulator. The idea now is that Wednesdays after Minecraft, I'm alternating between my Farming Simulator and Construction Simulator. So this week farming, next week construction, and so on. The stream quality is very low because of the top left camera. Thanks, Dave. Thanks, everybody. If you're sticking around for City Skylines, I will see you in a moment. Don't go anywhere.
Sim Life, Matt's gonna drive on down the track. Train Sim Life, it's good to see you for come back. Matt's right here.